When you put the rubato into strongly.
Okay.
Can you do it right now?
Just play that F chord.
Where, in the left hand?
Yeah.
aren't you?
I'm.
Stay. Can I try the mask?
Sure.
So, what's good about this? Give them some good feedback, please. Presentation is nice, yeah. In fact, we thought about it. I like the mask, I like the costume, it looks great. What else? Josh?
Your tone is really, really amazing. I love that.
Molly?
Energy is fantastic, really pushing through, because especially the last till I drink sing is open, it's great, and it's there. A lot of times I've heard people sing this and it's not there, and it's very energy flowing. You got the energy going, and you got the air flowing, it's great.
Enjoy it. I don't know this part of the family out there.
It's actually from the sequel to Family.
Right, written later.
Yep.
Love Never Dies, of course. I just don't know it at all. So, nice to hear. So, two things for you that I would think about working on.
Okay.
First is intentional movement.
Right.
And it's much better than it's been. But at one point when you're crossing the stage, you were crossing the stage like this, and I don't know if you realize that.
Oh, it
did. Right. And thankfully, you're having this recorded so you can watch the movements
okay.
as well. And even when you were singing, at one point you were doing things like this, which there's nothing wrong with expressing yourself like that. But that's not who the character is.
Right.
What is the character supposed to be? You can describe this man. Who is he?
Someone who in the past was broken, didn't understand love at all, and then finally understood it for the first time, and now has had to move on 10 years since he first learned what it was, looking back and realizing that without it, he's practically nothing.
Is he strong or weak?
He's strong in a strange way. Like, maybe not physically, but like mentally. I don't know.
I challenge you. I believe that the character is strong.
Yes.
This is my interpretation, but I think he's strong. And I think that movements like this are not showing strength.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And they're showing. I mean, what does this say to you right now?
Whatever.
What's that?
Whatever.
And it's what does this say to you?
Sassy queen.
Dr. Douglas is going to get fired from SAU is what it says, right? Yeah.
Well, and they're really like Lucasisms, like it's just ways that you naturally talk and express yourself when you're talking, which is great. But when you're on stage, you want to try to leave who you are behind and try to become the character.
Right.
So try to be really intentional about your movement instead of just letting your mind wander, because then you'll do what you naturally do.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Show me one pose of strength right now, though. I'm going to clap my hands and do it again. One, two, three, change strength. It's hard to do this, just so you know, to be on the spot
yes.
and do this. I know it's very, very unnerving, but you're acting, right? Can you show me one more position of strength? Don't think. One, two, three, go. Yeah. Play with this. Play this game and do it with your friends and find ways to show this masculine strength for you. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Great. Second thing. Is you're doing so much better, but I'm still hearing you hold the note before you sing it. And is there a better way to say that, Mrs. Douglas?
No, I think you've described it as like footballing a note, or instead of just opening, letting it go, right? We edit first, and then we say, okay, it sounds good, and then we let it go. You have to just open and go.
Open and go. Is there a spot of music where we can do that? Sandra's still here.
Let's
find a spot in music where we can just demonstrate you understand what we're saying. It feels like every single note you're slightly behind because you're trying to hear it in your head first and slowly emerging the sound. And I just want you to go. Does that make sense?
Okay.
As opposed to whoa, right?
Yep.
Can we just find one phrase to sing?
Okay.
We can do it both ways. Is there a spot that you have in mind, Emily?
Wherever you're comfortable, can you?
Where are you comfortable, Ed?
I don't know.
How about someplace on the second page?
Second page? Okay. What's on the second page? Edwards.
Okay.
Yeah.
And weeks pass into months pass, seasons
right there, right, Emily?
That's an issue of fear.
That's an issue of fear.
So
ways for us to show that you can demonstrate what you saw. I know this is hard to do in front of people, just so you know, but this is the best way to learn how to do this.
Okay.
And by the way, the second time through, this sounded great until the second grade. It really was open. The intervals were much more close.
Okay.
So nice work. So sing one more phrase and demonstrate what she's talking about with chewing and just getting the word out.
All right.
I'm just going to be scared of performing now. I'm sorry.
Not in the end, that was wonderful, but in the beginning part of it, your forte, your mezzo forte was very loud.
Yeah.
So I think you still are kind of, how many times have you played on this piano?
I practiced it a bit last night and this morning, so.
Yeah. It's hard to hear when you're up there in the, it's easier for us to hear the dynamics almost than it is to hear it when it's coming at you. So just have somebody listen and see if they think, how soft can your pianist will get on that instrument?
Yeah.
And then vary your dynamic levels in the beginning. Make sure you present yourself with posture that's, there you go. Because you started crouching at the beginning. And it's okay to kind of lean over the keys a little bit, I think, but just don't keep that rounded shoulder on the top part. Anyway, I loved it.
I loved it too. Amazing.
I think it was wonderful.
Excellent, excellent compositions.
You're speaking the levels of things, those surprise accents and sforzandos that we put in there coming through very well. So, but it just stays at one level too long, I think. Dynamic.
So we have a moment. I want to try to experiment. Is that okay?
Sure.
So I'm just thinking about this coach that I know, Coach Covenants. They, when they play opera scores, they have to play just pianist rehearsals for opera houses because they can't hire an orchestra for the whole time. So I was leaning over their shoulder once, and I saw in her score, she was writing vocal, and then she wrote flute, and then she wrote bassoon. She was thinking of those colors when she was playing, and it was amazing. I'm wondering for the waltz, is there a section where you could think orchestrationally? And as you think orchestration and change the orchestration, here I hear flute, here I hear this, or here I hear glockenspiel. And see if you could try to incorporate it. Maybe you think it's hogwash, I don't know. Is it worth a try?
It would be. I would just need to think about what it would be.
Think about it. We've got time.
It's like.
I heard spots in the walls that I would totally love to orchestrate that piece, just so you know, but it's yours, so.
Like. I think in the duet section, or not duet section, but like in the middle where it's like going between the left hand and the right hand, that would be one place to like bring out different colors for each part.
Show me.
So, I don't know which colors to bring out. Just
play with it for a minute. We've got time. Now the question is, did it change when you thought cello in your mind? And now our piano professor is saying, what's wrong with just thinking of a piano? It's a piano, right?
Oh no, orchestrating is what you have to do with Beethoven and
opera. So you do this as well?
With Mozart.
Good. I think it's helpful. I have nothing else to say, but this is just lovely. I would buy this music, just so you know.
Me too.
So, I think they both should be orchestrated, but I'm wondering how you would orchestrate that toccata for orchestra. That would be insane. But it's just lovely music. Any other questions, concerns, comments? Yeah.
Yeah.
I just thought you were so expressive, and it's funny because I sing with you all the time, and I don't ever really know what you're doing when I'm performing, and I kind of wonder if you're always expressive, and I just thought it's a really nice to hear you, but it's also nice to watch you, because a lot of times, you know, it's boring, but it wasn't boring, because you just move with the music so much.
Great.
And your song's not.
I love that as well, and I also want to reiterate what Professor Heidenberg said, in that you were grooving so hard in that second.
Yeah.
Grooving, and all of a sudden you're sitting there like this. I'm like, it's not working, you've got to show it more. And so what Annabelle said is relevant as well, that when it shows, it's really amazing. So I think I'm sick about your tongue. Get the neck going. Lily's got the neck going, right? Lily's got the stank face and the neck going. Anyway, yes.
Andrew, there's
you so much, Andrew. Thank you for playing. Josh, and you want short stick, no stick?
Liz, right now.
Liz, what?
Anyways, you bring forth such confidence And as if you studied it, if you haven't, then you should. We all should, so that we can bring that on stage. And so that's what you're presenting. You're definitely not, you know, bound. We're a lot of times we get so nervous and we're afraid to be expressive, right? So you're so expressive, but what I love mostly is that everything has a purpose in how you're using your body to express. And that's hard to do because, again, we get so locked up and nervous that we're afraid to even use our arms, or, you know, we get stuck in a certain part of the stage. And I love how you've been able to do that. Do you think, how do you think you've come to that ability to be able to sing and to act freely?
I think a lot of it is the acting, and a lot of it just comes as I grow and develop as a person, and I stop being afraid of like how I'm going to come across to people, and that just translates pretty well on stage. That I think just confidence in general improves confidence on stage.
Good, I love that. And you said acting, so you're in theater as well, mm-hmm. productions too, and so kind of taking that away, you know, just looking at acting outside of singing, just like we do when we practice our breathing, we practice it away from singing, and then putting that all back together again, you have that confidence of acting, and it shows. One thing that I'd love to encourage you to check in and just think about is the breath. It's so hard as singers, you know, and especially the more active we are, it can help or it can take away. And so just remember that low, deep breath and just keeping that. It's like a balloon of air that you have under your voice, right? Mm-hmm. That expansion. That you can keep. Can you just try from the beginning one more time? Or a favorite part that you have, it doesn't have to be the beginning.
You start the...
And just think, okay, get that low, deep breath. Maybe for now we can just, you're still acting, but, you know, check in at your stomach. Put your hand, one hand on your stomach, one on your rib, and just take a full, yeah, that's fine. Just a full breath.
Mother always said, be kind to strangers, but she doesn't know what they destroy. I can feel the clear and present dangers when she warns them.
You're breathing, that whole other area of our breath that we forget. But such a nice job today. I found it really, really entertaining, and I was pulled into your world, and that's just what we want as an audience. Any other comments?
I just have one thing, but I'm only a one-trick pony, so you've probably seen it before, but you're in the beginning, you're obviously supposed to be very dark and very gloomy, and then but I mean pulled in a different direction. I know it's a one trick, but are those different spots out in the house or something like that? You know what I mean? Can you see that you're standing there and you're like all dark and gloomy, but then there's the sunlight. But then I'm back to dark and gloomy, and those are specific physical spots out here in the house that you can see. Mm-hmm. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I think so.
Just play with it for one side.
Okay.
Can you start out, see a spot and you just see darkness, and then when you actually physically turn, you're being pulled in a different direction. Does it seem to be like Mickey Mousing? You know what I mean by that?
No, that makes sense. It's like telling the literal narrative, but in physicality, yeah.
Can you make a transition between those two? And
there might be an old person. It's kind of page two.
Through my painful pursuits of poverty's to root, all the things I detested and possibly cute.
That was the right word.
It works. So play with that idea. Such a nice job.
Yes.
Love watching you perform. Nobody can ever blame you of not bringing it.
You
always bring it, so excellent job. No matter how sorrowful that is, how sorrowful must it be for his mom, for Mary? It's just really dark and really heavy. So as you're telling the story, who are you and who are you? Who have you decided to be?
I've not actually decided, but I would say I am sort of a third party observing. Like, if I imagine myself, like, at Golgotha, I'm, like, in the back of the crowd seeing, like, the look on Mary's face.
So that's a possibility I haven't thought of, and I love that possibility. So we'll further with that. Even though, like, your jaw just dropping in the end, you could go further with that. Oftentimes when I see this, it's like someone who is a reporter, and they're just reporting on what happened. You know, reporters have got to keep it together. They can't be smiling and saying, and the bus plummeted into the river, killing 18 kids, right? They've got to say it in a way that is just reporting the facts, non-emotionally. And oftentimes I've seen that as well, so it's interesting to see the difference. Just something to think about. Who are you? Why does your music exist? And again, the ensemble is really super tight, so awesome. Any questions or anything you want to try again?
Can I try to hire a part with the FC if I can get
do it? Note
a little bit?
That's why we're here.
It was like the parting of day from night. The song was the suffering bird.
One more time.
Yeah, do it as many times as you need. When it cracks, don't worry about it. Can you help him with this, Emily? It flipped and all of a sudden you lost everything. I can see in your eyes, you're like, oh, I wish that didn't happen. Mrs. Simpson, I'm sorry I did that. Right? That's our mic. You don't want that to happen.
Yeah.
But it happens.
I liked it the first time you did it.
Yeah.
Okay. And I know from you, your perspective, it's hard because you're in the theater and you can't hear it like we hear it, right? Even as a singer, we can't hear ourselves resonate in the hall. We hear from the backside, the inside, right? This time, I felt like we were digging in too much in the lower register, right? And if we're expected to go up to the higher register, we can't have weight or dig in or, you know what I'm talking about, getting heavy?
I think so, yeah.
So staying wide, right, with the soft palate, with the breath, with the jaw, okay?
Okay.
Can you do that one more time, and can you just do the straw?
Yeah.
Okay, do your pretend straw and just do the whole thing.
It was like the parting of day from night. The song was the suffering one.
Great. So you had that breath behind you. You felt that, right? Did you feel like that was different than before?
Yeah. But.
So the only thing is once you have that all that breath, you can't push or you shouldn't push like you don't have to work as hard.
Yeah.
And then when we push, you know, we don't need to do that, but then the voice, you know, kind of cracks just a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
You want to try it one more time?
I would love
to. And then just balance that. You don't need to work as hard as what you've done before in the past. It's easy.
Be careful right now that you don't work so hard to not crack.
Okay.
Yeah. All you're doing, you're releasing the sound. The first time, I just loved how free it was.
Yeah.
And in your voice, right? Yes.
I don't know if you can tell, but that last time you just floated up to the note. And I think a lot of times, as someone who sings high a lot, when you sing high notes, you really want to push and want them to be loud and perfect and polished, and so it makes us push and try hard, and that's the hardest where we're working.
Yeah.
And that time it seemed like you weren't working as hard, there was less tension, and it just floated, and like we could hear it, and it wasn't cracking, and it was just so much better, even though it was softer.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Josh. Thank you, Andrew. Great ensemble. You guys are friends, right?
Hmm?
You're friends, right?
I hate him.
We have a last minute addition to the program. Shannon Duck is singing a song she's written her own recently written. Yes. Just wants to get our feedback on it.
But what I would probably suggest is just
thoughts, body?
I just think projection,
yeah.
Proper projection predominant, especially without mic.
Yeah.
Because you sound very similar to some other popular contemporary singers, secular and sacred. And so your words get clipped every once in a while, so it's hard to understand the text.
Mm-hmm.
So just, I think if you project past this, up to this section just a little bit more when you're singing.
Okay.
And the idea of not looking down at your instrument,
yeah.
Burying your voice with a really good tip. It's a very nice song, so we want to hear all the words.
Thanks.
Yeah.
That would be a little melodic term, but they just transport you to somewhere else, you know what I mean? Really, be careful with the strumming pattern. Sometimes it squares out.
I can't play ukulele, so yeah.
Well, you can shoot it in, so that's about the level of my ukulele.
Huh?
Sometimes it goes from being the swamp to being a little straight.
Yeah.
So just make sure it's right in the pocket because it pulls me out of the island, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
That's where I want to be right now. So, yeah, what a beautiful job. Great song. Any other questions, concerns? Thank you.